Few mythical creatures have been as enduring in pop culture as dragons. Magical, fire-breathing reptiles with bat-like wings that supposedly terrorized ancient peoples and burned cities. To this day, dragons are still just as popular as ever. So it begs the question, what if dragons actually existed? How would they have naturally evolved, and how would they have interacted with humans? These are the questions posed by Dragon's World, A Fantasy Made Real, a feature-length, speculative documentary that tries to scientifically explain the concept of live dragons. The film intertwines two separate narratives, a series of nature documentary-esque shorts depicting dragons throughout history, and a dramatization of a young scientist who believes in the existence of dragons and sets out to find proof, despite being scoffed at by his skeptical colleagues. Basically the main character from Disney's Atlantis. And just like in that movie, he of course turns out to have been right all along, finding and studying the preserved body of a real dragon. The shorts have some pretty entertaining concepts. The first is set in the Cretaceous period and depicts dragons living alongside dinosaurs, with the opening scene pitting a dragon against a T-Rex. It has a very primordial-looking backdrop of volcanic landscapes and some great action scenes of two dragons chasing each other through the skies. My one criticism is that I wish it had more scenes of these dragons interacting with dinosaurs. Quite honestly, this whole movie could have just been about Cretaceous dragons hunting Triceratops and fighting T-Rexes, and I'd be hooked. Afterwards, we get depictions of dragons throughout human history, featuring a snake-like dragon hunting in a forest, an aquatic dragon swimming through rivers like a crocodile, and finally ending on a more complete storyline of dragons living in the mountains trying to raise their young, only to be hunted by knights who view them as pestilence. This part is actually very emotional and surprisingly gets you to care a lot about this mother dragon and her baby, as you can't help but be saddened by the deaths of these innocent creatures. It was clear that they were trying to make a parallel to actual animals hunted to extinction by humans in the past and how wrong it is. I do have one problem with this segment though. I feel the designers made these dragons look completely unsuited for living in such a cold, snowy habitat. Seeing these thin, scaly reptiles walking through tunnels in the ice just looks wrong. Perhaps if they made them more mammalian, with thick fur coats or layers of fat traditional of Arctic mammals, or better yet, made them more bird-like, with wings and bodies covered with feathers for insulation, it seems like that would make more sense. The other part of the documentary, the aforementioned story of the scientists with his radical ideas about real dragons, is also pretty inventive. After he discovers the frozen body of a dragon, we learn about this creature and its anatomy as he does. The film offers scientific explanations about traditional dragon features, most notably how an animal could breathe fire by storing flammable gases like methane in its body and creating a spark with special minerals collected elsewhere. There's also some clever moments where the two narratives match up in certain ways. For example, our scientists learn the methods of how the dragon could fly, just as a baby dragon in the Cretaceous segment flies for the first time. However, there are quite a few things I felt could have been done differently in this area. For one thing, the film plays up these dragons as if they really existed, and all those dragon depictions throughout history were drawn from life.
These drawings aren't wild imagination. They're records. These primitive people were telling us something, and we weren't listening.
I think it would have been more interesting and more informative to actually explain why myths of dragons were created in the first place. Misunderstandings of early fossil discoveries, writing them off as the remains of supernatural monsters, before scientists learned to properly study and identify extinct creatures. Not to mention the ways in which slaying dragons was once considered a noble task comparable to fighting the devil and doing God's work, even though dragons were never actually seen. Perhaps if the movie started out covering the realities of dragons and how this idea shaped human history and culture, then speculated on what the world would be like if dragons were actually real and how our timeline would have been different, the documentary would have been better for it. Also, for all the talk about how dragons supposedly diversified and adapted throughout history, it never offers a scientific explanation of how dragons might have evolved in the first place. That, I thought, would have been an interesting subject to explore. Still, for all my issues with it, I think Dragon's World is a very interesting experiment in scientific speculation. The effects are decent, the stories are comprehensible and well-structured, and it was all around a nice idea for a documentary of sorts. It gave me an idea that maybe someone could make a documentary going through this process of speculation with other mythical creatures, like unicorns, hydras, krakens, and others, each time explaining how the myths originated, what parts, if any, are scientifically plausible, and how they might have evolved in the first place. That would be quite interesting to see. But until then, Dragon's World, A Fantasy Made Real, remains a unique, fictional documentary that serves as great entertainment. Thanks for watching! If you enjoy my videos and want to support future projects, click the Patreon link in the description. You'll also receive benefits like early access to videos,